Welcome to Revelation Unraveled. I'm your host, William Tapley, also known as the Third Eagle of the Apocalypse and the Co-Prophet of the End Times. It looks as if I will be doing quite a few videos on this crisis in the Middle East. As you know, President Barack Obama has said that he intends to declare war against Syria and to bomb Damascus. And he is seeking congressional approval because he wants to do more than just fire a shot across the bow, as he previously declared was his only intention. And I am convinced that this will lead to the Daniel 9 war. And the Daniel 9 war is very serious, because in chapter 9, verse 26, the great prophet says that Jerusalem will be destroyed. And please don't listen to the false prophets all over YouTube who say that this war is the Ezekiel 38 war. That is a grave error. The Ezekiel 38 war refers to Armageddon. That comes at the end of the tribulation. The Daniel 9 war comes at the beginning of the tribulation. And that is the terrible catastrophe that is about to occur. And Pope Francis has recognized the seriousness of this war in the Middle East, and he has declared this Saturday, September 7th, to be a worldwide day of prayer and fasting. And I want to show you this headline from the Huffington Post. Pope Francis calls for peace in Syria, announces worldwide day of fasting on September 7, 2013. So let me read excerpts from this article. Pope Francis on Sunday condemned the use of chemical weapons, but he called for a negotiated settlement of the civil war in Syria and announced he would lead a worldwide day of prayer and fasting for peace there on September 7th. My heart is deeply wounded by what is happening in Syria and anguished by the dramatic developments on the horizon, Francis said in an apparent reference to the U.S. and France considering a military strike to punish the Syrian regime for a chemical weapons attack. Usually soft-spoken, Francis raised his voice as he declared, "War brings on war. Violence brings on violence." His admonishment against resorting to arms as a solution recalled the repeated emotional implorations a decade ago. Now listen to this. This is very interesting. By the late Pope John Paul II, in a vain attempt to persuade the U.S. administration, then led by President George W. Bush, not to invade Iraq. Pope John Paul II was 100% correct. And Pope Francis is correct now. We should never bomb Syria. This will be a worse mistake than bombing Iraq, and it is going to lead to the destruction of Jerusalem as prophesied by Daniel in 926. And the Pope continued, Francis invited Catholics, other Christians, those of other faiths, and non-believers who are men of goodwill to join him that evening in St. Peter's Square to invoke the gift of peace for Syria, the rest of the Middle East, and worldwide where there is conflict. The deteriorating drama of Syria inspired Francis to set aside September 7th as a day of fasting and prayer for Syria. He said the prayer vigil in the square will last from 7 p.m. until midnight, and that would be approximately Saturday afternoon, Eastern Standard Time. Of course, it varies around the world. I personally will be praying a rosary for peace in Syria. And that leads me to my next email, and this is from Daniel John 2300. And he posted a comment on my last video. And by the way, Daniel John 2300 has some very interesting videos you may want to watch. And here's what he said. Hi, William. I don't know which video to post this on, but I just listened to Catholic Answers, and they said that Genesis 3:15 should say, "He will crush the serpent." They did not deny that Mary, along with the rest of the church, crushes the serpent too, but they did say that no council ever approved the translating of that word as she, and that the correct translation is he. I was wondering if you had heard anything about this. Well, I have gone over this numerous times here on YouTube. The correct translation is she will crush the head of the serpent. And this is found in Genesis 3:15, as Daniel John 2300 notes. Let's take a look at that critical passage from the Old Testament. And the reason I want to look at Genesis 3:15, because there is a reason I am praying the rosary for the situation in the Middle East. And that's because Mary is prophesied to crush the head of the serpent. And of course, the serpent is Satan. In Genesis 3:15, God says, I will put enmity between you, that is the serpent, and the woman. And the woman is Mary. Now this is the first struggle in this passage. And now let's look at the second struggle. And your seed and her seed. Now I put these in two different colors so you can see that there are two different struggles referred to. And then God refers back to the struggle between Mary and the serpent. And she shall crush your head. He is still talking to the serpent. And you shall bruise her heel. There can be no other way to translate the word except she, not he. Now, in the original language, it could be either. You had to go by the context. But the context here is very clear. God is still talking to the serpent, and the struggle is between the woman and the serpent. And so I want to thank Pope Francis for calling for this worldwide day of prayer for peace in the Middle East. And we are going to need all the help we can get. There's no doubt that President Obama is hell-bent on bombing Syria. And Mary's Rosary will ultimately defeat the Antichrist, but not until after Syria destroyed and we face the 3.5 years of tremendous tribulation. And please don't forget my bumper sticker offer. If you would like a free bumper sticker to display anywhere, not just on your automobile, in order to help promote my YouTube ministry, simply send me a self-addressed stamped business envelope to the address you see on your screen.